God damn it, the music changed. All right, well, anyway. I don't love the 2 p.m. music. I had it on 1 p.m. for a reason, but I'll survive. Yeah, cold open. Hello, welcome. My name is Amelia, and if you would like, you can call me Kit Kat. I got that nickname from a friend, and I think it's really cute, which is why I used it for this YouTube channel. So, I'm doing a take two. My previous take had crackling in the audio, and the problem that I end up having is that the crackling doesn't actually show up until I review the footage, and so I spent 30 minutes on this already. So anyway, we're back. I thank you for watching my video. If this is one of my family members or my friends, hi. If this isn't, hi. Welcome to IHOP. Welcome to my entrance. So I built this entrance. This was close to one of the first things I did when I was revamping my island. I wanted to make something cool, and so I was building up cliffs on either side of the walkway between my airport and my town square, and I decided to just close it in and add an incline. Alright, I am back. We are going to continue with this. I just had to check in with one of my parents. So, anyway, this is my entrance. I have a stegosaurus here because I love stegosaurus and I love dinosaurs, so here's a fossil. Up here, my island fruit is apples, so I have an apple tree. I think roses are my favorite flower IRL or in the game, so I decided that my island flower would be roses, even though it was originally wind flowers. So anyway, coming over here, this is my sort of crossroads. Over to the right, I have an orchard. It's got a bunch of fruit. I used to use this to make money, and now that I have enough money to live comfortably, I don't need it. It just looks cute. Up here I have a zen garden area. Apparently everyone needs one on their island, and this is mine. You can come up here, you can take a little break, you can have some food. My island is pretty ladder heavy. There are quite a few little places you can only get to if you have a ladder, and that's one of them. So then over here, my island is a little bit of a maze, so I have signposts everywhere. I guess I can show my map now. This is my map. I use a custom design for my pathing, so you can't really see any pathing on here. But, you know, it's a little bit of a maze. These are my villagers. I have Daisy and Agnes and Sterling, Nox, Deirdre, Hornsby, Megan, Zell, Amelia, and Ruby. And yes, this Amelia spells her name the same way as I do. That's originally why I got her. I thought it was funny. So anyway, that's my map. These are my custom designs. So I get most of these, I find them on Pinterest or pretty much just Pinterest. I'll have the creator codes or design codes for all of the ones that I use around my island in my description. So I think this is the one noteworthy one that you'll see the most. This is a brown brick version of the path, and the creator has a bunch of different colors for this, so you can go check them out. I wanted a little bit of a different version of the path, but I do think the path looks super cool, so that's why I've got this. Yeah, it gives my island a little bit of a city feel, a little bit of a foresty feel, which I enjoy. You might notice it's currently November 17th in my game. In real life, it's the 16th of December, but I think my island looks the best in the fall, so this is what you get. Over here, I have a horse pasture. I needed to fill in space and I had a ton of softwood, so that's what I made. It's funky. It makes no sense. It has no purpose, but it makes this walkway interesting. Over here is my first residential area. I ended up having my residence kind of split into girls and boys, which I didn't intend. But if you care, this is the boys area. I have Knox's house here. His theme is like pretty golden. I mean, he's got a golden head anyway, a golden helmet. So that's why it's all yellow. Gold roses over here. Over this way, deer just hanging out. I love her lipstick, it's totally cool. Pumpkin patch, what is this? The path, the thing along the side of all of my flower beds. It's something I made, and it's really crap, but it does the job. Oh, Sterling's thinking about something. I'll talk to him later. Over here is my first trash heap. I have a few of these around my island, just to fill in space. You could probably define my island as cluttercore, I guess. I don't have a way to define it. I made the island, and this is what it looks like. So, this is Hornsby's house. He's a little bit tucked away. He's got a bed because he's a lazy villager. He probably likes to nap. Over here, a bridge, and then some beach towels. These are decoration. It's not that I forgot to pick them up, I just thought, you know, why not throw them there? Down here, this is probably the one area that is unchanged from the start. So I made this early on in my game, and I spruced it up a little bit by adding the gold roses. But other than that, it's the one unchanged part on my isthmus. If that's the wrong word for that, you can correct me. So I'll come back up here, and continuing on. This is Sterling's house, and Deirdre's house are in this area. Deirdre's house is very fall themed inside. She has maple leaves falling on her as her wallpaper. So this is my mimicry of it. I just kind of made it fall as well. Sterling is over here, and I guess I'll talk to him and see what's up. Oh. Alright. If you want, you can also call me Mimi. That's what my villagers call me. He lives in a jail. I think he's supposed to be the guard, like the guard of the prisoners, but it's a little bit off-putting. So I kind of just made this a little bit run down. Anyway. Over here is my shopping area where my shops are. Able Sisters, I have a little, what would you call this? I don't know. It's a stand. It's got some stuff on it. And then vending machines, and then back here I have a bench you can sit at and overlook the secret beach and all of the ocean beyond. And then come back, and down here, this is Nook's Cranny. Again, a little stall out front. I sit here when I have people come by to sell turnips or whatever. I'm not super active on Reddit, but I do that sometimes. So that's what's going on here. Again, my island looks best in fall, and I still haven't replaced all of my pumpkin decorations, so. Then over here, a little bit tucked away, this is Zell's house. There's a nice prospect of it from over this river. But, you know, it is what it is. He's chic, so I have some black tulips. Over here is my moon island. I wanted to have something cool here, and unfortunately no one really sees it, because if you're walking up on the path up there, you're not gonna see it, and if you're over anywhere else, it's covered by some cliffs, so it's just a little secret. And I have some cosmos and some roses, because those are the two flowers I chose to be my island's flowers. So, again, signposts leading you around the island. This is my plaza. God, Nox, you're not gonna catch anything in the waterfall. I have back here a secret soundtrack. My favorite so far, my favorite KK piece is KK Soul. So I've got KK Soul playing back here. You don't really hear it unless you're right up on there, but I like it. So this is here. I doubt anyone will ever visit me through a dream address, but if they do, they'll need a ladder. So I put that there for their sake. I swear I hear a balloon. If I'm going crazy, I'm going crazy. I think I'm going crazy. Okay, that's fine. So over here is my campsite. I of course have this campsite sign that you can get from playing Pocket Camp. I like this campsite. There are many parts of my island I'm not satisfied with, which is why I'm rebuilding. And I'll get to that. I'll let you know how that's gonna go soon. But you know, I like this part. It's kind of cute. Up there I have another fossil, I have another dinosaur. As I said, love dinosaurs, love fossils, so I just tucked it in here. I swear to God, if... I don't know if you can hear that too, but I swear I'm hearing a balloon and it's driving me nuts! Anyway, I'll come back over here. And this is one of my favorite parts of my entire island. It's my rainbow flower field. So every single iteration of my island so far, I've always had a flower field, and this time I made it rainbow. Pink over this way, and then blues and purples and black on the other side. So again, I've got a fossil, I've got some flamingos, I have a bench, you can sit down, I have some beehives, so they can pollinate the flowers, get that good honey. And as you can see, it turns purple and black, and then blue, and then white, etc. So I'll definitely be keeping this in some capacity when I redo, but that's what that is. There's so many good angles for this. I like it so much. Down here I have my first beach build. Again, quite cluttered, but more functional than the other ones, definitely. Lay down, listen to some tunes. That's pretty much all that is. I'm gonna come over this way. Again, need a ladder for this. This is my main flower breeding area. So if you know anything about flower breeding in this game, and if you've tried to breed blue roses before, you might recognize this, because I am literally the only flower I'm missing. The only color I'm missing of any flower is blue roses. So this is my blue rose breeding operation. It used to be green mum breeding, but I finally got green mums. So that's all that is. And it's gonna take me forever, but I'm dedicated, so it'll be okay. Down here, this has a story. Again, I was trying to fill in some space, and I made these boys, and I find them so funny. So I set this area up like they're swindlers, kind of like Red. They're trying to sell you stuff, and they're totally ripping you off. This guy has a bingo ball thing, and he's like, step up, win a prize! You step up, and you never win a prize. It never happens. This is, of course, a fake statue. Again, they're swindling you. This is their back room. They have some questionably kept fish, and other items that they might be wanting to sell in the near future. Got my skeleton. It's one of the silliest items, I swear. I find it so funny. again, KK Soul. There you go. I love that. It's so nice. And then we will come back this way. And this is my museum. Which I will get to in a second. over to the left here is my pumpkin patch, which of course I was using a lot during October to make pumpkin DIYs. And I don't really need it anymore. It's gonna be one of the things that's the first to go when I redo my island, but you know, for now, it's here. And then I will go back. So, my museum. It is very much Halloween themed, but I find it very satisfying. It's symmetrical. It's got a homogenous sort of, or a harmonious color scheme. Yellow, orange, red, etc. I love the symmetry of it. I have a T-Rex and a Triceratops fossil here. It's just nice. I like it. But it's not perfect. I'll be improving that at some point. Following the signs, this leads back to some more houses. So, back here is my house, up to the left. I recorded a house tour when I did my first try of this video, and my house isn't gonna change when I change my island, and the point of filming this is I am going to change my island. So maybe I'll do a house tour at some point, but for now, I'm just gonna do the exterior. This is trash heap number a million. I don't even know how many trash heaps I have, but this one just goes on and on and on, until back here where I have these two little seats, and it's so cute if I have friends visiting. We just sit here together. I love it. So that's that. Again, overlooking the water. And I'll come back over this way and we'll see some more houses past my trash heap. And so here I have another house sign that leads back to Daisy's. So this is Daisy's house, one of the first house areas I made. It's very, very cute, very simple. Honestly, the white cosmos make me think of daisies, and that's why they're here, because she's Daisy. She's so darling, as you might know if you have her. And you know, she's a normal villager. All the normal villagers are darling. Up here, I made this another trash heap, not one that anyone ever sees, including myself, but it's here, so there you go. I wanted to make stuff. I wanted to build some stuff, I wanted to customize some stuff, and I just threw it there. And then back over here, this is Amelia's house. Red and white kind of themed. I mean, she's red and white and blue, and she's got some black on her. She wears a black sweater. Very chic. So that's that. This is my second orchard. This was not an orchard by design, it was kind of an orchard of convenience. I needed some fruit, I needed to fill some space, so I made this. And then over here, again, signs. So this bridge goes back towards my museum, and then these point towards the shops, which are over there. And then the houses, so Amelia's and Daisy's and mine are over that way. Up here, again, house sign, I have another dinosaur. It's a common theme. Back here is Megan's house. Megan is a bear, so I put her in a little bit of a cave, and she loves books and she loves reading, so I made her a little reading nook. And she's purple and she has the cutest little yellow freckles, which is why her colors are purple and yellow here. And then this is Ruby's house. Ruby's house is the one I'm dissatisfied with. I feel so bad. Like, she's the coolest bunny. She's a space bunny. She has spaceships. She has a space shuttle. She has astronaut outfits. She's got a space rover. She's got everything. And her exterior is country fence and a garden lantern and this. I feel bad. She deserves better. So when I rebuild, she's getting something better. It's gonna happen. It's absolutely happening. Okay. And then this is a very special villager house. A very special sign pointing to a very special villager. And this lily is a clue. A pink lily. If you also have Agnes, you might have recognized that. So this is Agnes's house. Agnes is generally my favorite villager. I have trouble picking favorites. There's so many good villagers, but for posterity's sake, she's my favorite villager. She is my starting sisterly villager. I did kick her out and remove her in so she can get her actual house rather than her starter villager house. But she's still my very dear Agnes. She's a black and white pig, and she wears a pink dress by default, and so I gave her black and pink. That's pretty much it. But she's my queen, so she's up here on Mount Crumpet, this winding path. And as a little secret, I have a completely accessible path right there. Agnes was not able to come down and play with everyone very often because she would have to walk all the way back around there, and I felt bad, so I kind of hid this away here so that she can come easier to see everyone. So then we're back in the shops, and this is the last part of the tour. Back here is my secret beach, and I have a danger sign as kind of a humorous little detail, because Red is not actually dangerous, he just wants to take your money. But this is where he comes. I love when people build like a sort of pirate theme with all of these like barrels and like barbed wire and stuff back here. I think it's really cool. I think it's dope as fuck, and I probably will do something like that when I redo. But right now it's just cute, it's just fun. It's got yellow, you know, it's fine. So anyway, that is my island tour. I, as I've probably mentioned multiple times, but did not mention when I did my introduction and when I said hello, I am rebuilding my island. I'm going to completely destroy it. I'm taking all of my items off the ground. I'm putting them in my storage. I'm moving all the villager houses onto the beach. I am taking down all of my cliffs. And I am going to rebuild. I have, I think, about like 8 different designs for my island, and I happened upon my favorite design on my design number 3. So I already have a plan of what it's going to look like. And therefore, I am recording this because I love my island now, but I want to change. And I want to save this island in the state that it is. I don't know how long my dream address will be active. I don't know how long this is going to take me. Everything's a question mark. But I'm really pumped. I'm really fucking excited. And I don't know. If I upload more videos, I hope you'll join me. I think it'll be cool. I think it might be refreshing. I love watching people build stuff, and I love destroying all of the stuff that I've built, and I also love rebuilding all of the new stuff. So regardless, this will be a big undertaking, and I hope you'll join me for it. So without further ado, see you later.